Here we go. Come with me. There's a world out there that we should see. Take my hand. Close your eyes. With you right here, I'm a rocketeer. Let's fly. Let's see back. Seatbelt, and I'll put my harness shoulder. Avionics, they're all off, right? Nope, they weren't. Someone is not doing their job, are they? Carby off.
Is there a master avionics?
Huh?
Yeah, but there's a master avionics. You don't have to turn them off if you have a master avionics.
Well, it can send a surge to it.
For all the years I'm flying, I never turn them off. I always use the master avionics.
That's what the checklist is here, so I'll follow that. Make sure you're on throttle, all right. Prime. Do we want to prime, or do we do the same thing last time?
Yeah.
While I'm cranking? All right. All right. Wanna... So make sure in, it was in, right? For this one? Make sure full ridge, yep. All right, so master on. Flip prop. Here we go. Switch then.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah, I hear you. Can you hear me?
Hold on a second. Test, 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 test.
My thing is not turning on, though.
Test, 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 test. Test, 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 test. Test, 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 test. All right, good.
Now, there we go. All right. December, that's the obstacle database, aviation database, July 23, okay. How do I know if this is on nav or VOR?
Because this is GPS on it.
Okay, so 90, yeah, close enough, and then turn this to 120. It's a little off, isn't it?
That's fine. It's supposed to be like that.
Why do you say that?
Because it's setting as a test. Saying that I evened out.
Alright, so let's do direct.
Talk again.
1-2, can you hear me? How's that? Is it better?
Yeah.
Alright, M. P. H. Marathon.
Yeah, when they say avionics off, they mean by the master, not by each individual one.
Well, the other one didn't have an avionics switch,
yeah.
So they were telling me to turn off.
If it doesn't have it, then yes,
yeah.
You need to do it like that.
I didn't realize that was the avionics switch.
If it has an avionics master, that's why it's built like that.
All right, so let's go to 133.0. And then here... tower is probably going to be
18.7. 18. Aircraft contact clearance will be first. 13.0. Attention all aircraft, simultaneous approaches being conducted to parallel runways. Notice airman bird activity on and in the vicinity of the airport. There's a TFR in effect 1,000 feet and below, about approximately 10 miles east of the field. Advise on initial contact. You have information. Uniform.
Where's that TFR? East of the field?
Miami Executive Information Uniform, 165 pay observation, wind 13012, visibility 10. Fuel cars at 4,300, 6,000 scattered. Temperature 33, dew point 22, altimeter 3008. ILS runway 9 right or GPS runway 9 left approach is in use. Then the departing runway is 9 left or runway 9 right. All helicopters in aircraft inbound from the north, contact turn on 134.6. All aircraft inbound from the south, contact turn on 118.9. Ground control is 0121.7. All fixed wing departing aircraft contact clearance will be first at 133.0. Attention all aircraft, simultaneous approaches are being conducted to parallel runways. Notice airman bird activity on and in the vicinity of the airport. There's a TFR in effect 1,000 feet and below, about approximately 10 miles east of the field. Advise on initial contact. You have information.
Yep.
Uniform.
So 10 miles east of, yeah, good. So.
Yeah, we're not going to worry about that. We're not going to be. Turn your, turn the bug to 218.
Why is it not going away?
It will, watch. Now it's away.
Oh, on the other one it went away on its own. Alright, so uniform, TFR over there. We're gonna ask for a flight following. When I call, I just say my type and requesting flight following to Marathon.
Yep.
And he'll give me a squawk code, and that's it, right?
Yep. And tell him you like runway 9 or right.
He'll give us runway 9 or right since we're on this side. I thought you were going to tell me 13. I'm like, well, what was I going to ask? Do you know the frequencies for what we're going to be en route and all that?
Yeah, I'll get it.
All right. All right, let's do a brake check.
I did.
And my brakes are good, so let's go. Now apparently the club is having a meeting, so they're all going to be watching, I'm sure. I'm 1133.0, I guess there's just no one calling. Six four four two. Good morning, Tamiami clearance. Skyhawk 64429er at spot 14 with information uniform. Would like a flight following to Marathon, Mike Tango Hotel.
At, you got it on altitude.
64429, executive clearance, what's your altitude requesting?
2,500 for 29er.
No, 64429, departure frequency will be 125.5, squawk 0070.
Departure frequency 125.5, squawk 0070, 429er.
I verify you at spot 17?
14.
Negative, we're at spot 14.
429er, ground 1.7, good day.
0.7, have a good day, 429er. All right, so 0070. Is there an enter? No, that's it?
That's it.
All right, so then departure is going to be 125.5, you said?
Yep.
So might as well put that here.
I'd put 121.7 on the bottom, just so you can test the transmit and receive on radio 2.
Okay, we'll set him over there then. You want to put 125.5 here?
No, yeah, 125.5 here. And then down here we put...
Yeah, we'll do it over there then. Well, I got to switch over so we can put it right now, I guess. 125. Oh, don't.
Yeah, you're good.
No, no, I got one, ground already.
That's okay. You want to check the second radio.
Oh, okay.
You don't want to check it in the air.
Where's that Miami ground? The Skyhawk 64429er at spot 14 radio taxi.
64429er, executive ground, runway 9 right via Echo, cross runway 13.
Runway 9 right via Echo, cross runway 13. 64429er.
18.9, right?
118.9.
Ground, runway 12803, Alpha 1, clear left.
Executive ground, spot 4B Alpha.
Yeah, Alpha 4.
Echo, which one is Echo now?
Ground 16, you got well. Echo 4 to customs.
Well, this one here, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Zero Golf Golf, executive ground, what's your parking again?
Echo 4 customs.
Zero Golf Golf customs, taxi via Echo Delta.
Echo Delta customs, Golf Golf.
Can you do me a favor?
What?
The my bag, the top pocket, it's a small like oval pack. There's a sunglasses pouch in there. Thank you. And I keep banging my head on this thing.
Put it on the other side. Put it forward.
Alright, runway 13, and then I don't see anyone on the final. That one just looks clear. So she usually works on the weekends, or?
Every other weekend.
No. Too bad she was working this one.
It'd be hard for us to get all of three of us in there.
Oh, she can't wait that much. There's a 800, I think it was like 840 something.
Oh, okay, it was 840 something.
And the tank's full is 38. I'd have to check again, but I think it would have been fine. Alright, where's that checklist? Wanna call him off or do I do it?
No, I'll watch you.
Alright.
We got a good practice.
Got your seatbelts. I should put this on. Wanna put yours as well or?
Already got it.
Look at you, already did it. Things are a pain in the butt. Come on. Yes, it's on both. This is like trim position. Good. Then avionics, we got transponder on standby. ATIS, I got altimeter. 3008. There you go. The right altitude, good. Radio we checked already. Taxi light, landing lights on. What'd you do? Oh, corrected the
Yep.
3's. Turn coordinator, compass, good. Brakes holding, you got yours?
Yep.
Case. Fuel on both I did. Trim, flight controls, I checked that now. This one goes up. See, goes up, goes down. Over it up, over it down. Left rudder, right rudder. Alright, flight controls are incorrect. Instruments we check. Best power prime. Alright, so full mixture. P900.
Can't read that.
That's my strobe. I don't know why you did it there. Normally I do it after. Alright, here we go. Left mag. About 50. Back on both. 1700.
935 Romeo, right. Turn left at Echo 2, ground point 7, have a wonderful
about
weekend.
100, going back on both.
Thank you, so have a good day.
Difference of 50, well. We're good.
Ground, full disfavor.
I will hear shortly.
On this side, so fuel, green, amp is charging. That looks good, no high voltage. I think everything else is good.
Alternate air is good.
Yeah, I checked that already when we left. So that's good, let's go to idle. Idle, we still have full tanks. Green, and zero on the amps, no high voltage. Good.
That's good.
Yeah, I checked that also, thank you, good. Amps, we're good, all pressure, temperature, idle check is checked. That's the only thing we haven't checked. Go back to 1700 on the, I forgot to do the carb. Alright, so carb in, drops a little bit, doesn't go back in, goes back 17, let's do idle check.
I'm Executive Saratoga, November 46, Romeo, Romeo with you for the 919.
We're good. Alright, flaps, we're at zero right now.
Yep.
Alright, mixture, best power, carb off, heading compass we did, doors, I'll get the window. Transponder, we got our code. Altitude.
We're on standby.
There put it in altitude mode.
No, watch. I just leave it on standby.
You want to see it go automatic? Alright. Alright, emergency plan. So here, if I'm on the runway, we have an issue. I'll brake, idle, get off the runway. Above at 500. Make a right to the. What?
Make a left.
Why left? We're going to be over the other runway.
That's the whole point. If you have an emergency and you have to land, don't you want to land on the runway?
Okay, every training scenario with my instructor has been we turn the other way.
I would always go towards a runway that I could, I could land on versus try to
I would go to 3-1 here.
He can make it. At least still turn. Oh, still turn towards the runway.
And this one over 5-7-5-2-2-2-1-7.
Above 1,000, we'll come back here for sure.
Ground 17, be echo cross runway 13.
Be echo cross runway.
While we're in transit, if there's an issue, you're going to put your safety vest and we'll open the doors, gem them up. I'll call, or you call and I fly. Yep. I guess that's probably smarter to do, right? Anything else you want to add to the plan?
Nope, just wanted to check the suction.
And
the other thing is, if you're going to do an extended... If you're going to do...
Where is it? I didn't check for the fire extinguisher. It
doesn't have one.
It doesn't. It's supposed to, I thought. Alright. So, takeoff, rotate 55, VY at 78.
The only thing is, if you're going to stay here for a while, pull it back.
Yeah, well, I was planning on leaving, but yeah. You're right. Good, anything else you want to add?
Nope.
Alright, Lord, keep us safe today as we go. Brake release. So, you put me in what now? I guess I'll swap over here.
No, you're in ground still. Stay in ground there.
Oh, yeah. And I get a call first. So we'll go there first. All right. So, Miami ground, 429er, run up complete.
Our 429er, monitor tower 118.9er.
118.9er, 429er.
No, put up here.
All right.
There you go. I always keep the flight stuff up here and the ground stuff down here.
One way. One on final. Looks clear.
Yeah, if you have parallel runways and you have an emergency and engine out, go towards a runway. Don't go towards congested, populated areas with power lines and no fields. At the end of the day, you're the one that has to live. And hopefully
I'll have to ask the control tower what they prefer in that kind of situation.
If it's
do what they say.
If it's an emergency, they'll if someone's on final, they'll push them and go around because you take priority because you're emergency.
You gotta make sure you tell them right away.
Absolutely, but that's the whole point.
Yeah.
An emergency, and I'm gonna turn to the left and try to land on a... They'll clear you any runway. That's what they'll say. Clear land any runway. They're not going to tell you to land one runway.
No, no, I know that.
So always go towards the runway. Any instructor that told you differently is an idiot. You have your nav lights on.
Nav lights are here.
Oh, well, all the lights are on.
I put the beacon, the strobe, and my taxi landing. Guess I don't need taxi.
The interior lights are on. I don't know why.
The what?
Number 64429, executive tower runway, 9er right, line up and wait, traffic 7 mile final.
Line up and wait, 429er.
6 Romeo, Romeo, turn left at Echo 3, ground point 7.
Point 7, Echo 3, 46 Romeo, Romeo.
ADF 1, 2 Delta, traffic holding in position prior to your arrival.
Okay.
November 64429, runway 9 right, clear for takeoff.
Runway 9 right, clear for takeoff, 64429. Make sure you're full in, right rudder.
Window.
ADF 12 Delta, runway 9 right, clear for land.
Got it.
9 right, clear for land, ADF 12 Delta.
Shoot. Hold that way.
Alright,
I got the control.
Alright.
Thank you. Wow, it's not climbing quite easily today, huh? Did it go to altitude? Oh yeah, look at that. That's pretty cool.
Didn't think I knew what I was talking about.
No, I knew, but I'd never actually seen it myself.
There's 64429, search your right, turn southwest now. Maintain to be a foreign contact departure.
Turning right to the southwest, 64429er. And standard rate of turn, right?
Yep, that ball.
Yep, and I'm trying, I'm starting to wonder if I didn't sit too far back.
Contact.
I have a few aircraft that are going the same way.
Oh, you did?
Okay, Roger.
I didn't hear
you.
November 7, Lima Golf, you should be through the light to moderate precipitation
so
in the next 1.07 miles.
This I tell
DB
my partner
that
one altitude number?
135.6.
Alright, 66.
And this is what, Tiki Miami departure?
1400, turn right heading 180.
Miami departure.
I can 180, American 1400.
Miami departure, Skyhawk 64429er, departed the Tamiami. We're currently at 1000.
November 64429, Miami departure, ready to contact maintain VFR.
Maintain VFR, 429er.
November 0, Alpha Lima, do you want the visual approach or the ILS?
Visual approach, 0 Alpha.
Roger.
Okay, there's my tower. I'm like, where is it?
Yep. Miami, American 1429. Was that expedited at a 5 or 1-5,000?
No, it's perfect. Thank you, American 1429. Yeah. Traffic no faster.
Here's a question for you.
6,
I didn't realize this until now.
American 1429. Did it tell you a heading?
No, just VFR.
So then I'll go that way.
Eastern 3153, contact Miami Center, 135.6.
We'll go see it.
I won't get too close. Yeah, we should be fine. Have you ever noticed there's supposed to be a gap here, or is it supposed to be flush on the throttle?
No, this gap is fine.
Okay. Well, we told them 2500 with my airspace here.
It doesn't matter. They told you to clear the airspace.
Oh, right? Oh yeah. That's
lower.
The fun thing about...
November 0, Alpha Lima, Roger, standby.
Traffic.
Why are you turning?
Because we got to go
for a 1429, contact Miami Center, 124.7, good day.
You're close to that tower.
Good day, American 1429.
Roger, good afternoon, San Francisco, 3 out of 1, 5,000, 0, 5,000.
You have a 703 heavy member departure, ready to contact line maintain 16,000.
Look.
16,000.
Traffic.
Yeah, I just don't want to fly too close to this antenna. You're supposed to be what? Is it 2,000 feet away?
You're above it.
No, you're not above it here. We're at the same height.
1,800. I'm watching it.
The tower, I think, is 2,300.
Right, 939 Fox.
You're above it, you're good.
Yeah, the airfield, but what about the antenna?
Maybe Roger.
What's the antenna height?
1,400 VFR, are you familiar with the Channel 6 antenna?
Who did you call?
1,429er?
Yeah.
Yes, we're got it at the antenna inside, 1,429er.
1,429er, on course at your discretion, use caution for the antennas, climb at your discretion.
On course to, Marathon at 2,500, 1,429er.
Zero for Lima, descend to maintain 2,000, reduce speed to 170.
2,000, 100, 0 for Lima.
Tampa 703 heavy, turn riding 180.
180, Tampa 903 heavy.
Max 1,400, turn left turning 170.
So there could I just said on course at 2,500.
Max 1,429, contact Miami Center 124.7.
It's your discretion, you want to go up higher? Go up higher. Let's go up a little higher.
Yeah, I'm just letting you know what my intentions are.
Max 1,429, contact Miami Center 124.7. November 0, Alpha Lima, do you have the field?
And I'm not used to this radio call.
0, Alpha Lima, good visual approach, runway 9R8, maintain 2,000 until midfield down one. Contact
you okay with the volume,
or is it too high?
I'm good. 118.9,
0, Alpha Lima, thank you.
November 14, contact, homestead approach 123.8.
Go ahead, 123.8, 1429.
American 1400, contact Miami Center 135.6.
That's what, homestead departure?
357.
Yep.
How many miles are we from Tamiami?
That's alright, just call it.
Okay. Homestead departure, Skyhawk 64429er, south of the Tamiami Airport at 2600.
Skyhawk 64429er, homestead approach altimeter 3008. Caution for the Channel 6 antenna, maintain VFR.
3008, and watching for the antenna, 429er.
34? No, but what was the squawk code?
It wasn't squawk code. It was the altitude.
It said 6442.
No, he gave you altimeter.
Oh, man. I thought he did read the altimeter after 3008.
Yeah, but he wasn't telling you to change the squawk code.
Alright, I'm gonna have to listen to that thing on the radio again. On the video, I mean. It'd be nice to have your feature, right? Playback.
Yeah, let's go 3500.
What's the airspace here?
You could go up to 3500, you're good. You're an echo. If they tell you out to your discretion, then you're clear to go, whatever you need to go.
Okay.
And then, that's your on course. You can use this. What's good about this is it shows you your track and your bearing. So you have to head.
Does that track take into, it doesn't
everything.
Take into account wind
everything.
And all that?
Everything.
Where's the wind? Would you like to go ahead, sir? I'll show you at 3,300. My airspace stops at 3,000.
Roger. 429er, can we go up to 4,500?
This Skyhawk 429, I'll hand you off to Miami South Departure if you want to go that high. Stand by.
Roger, wake up, 3-4. 2
Do I level here until they...
No, they'll hand you off. So...
What about those clouds, man?
If we need to stay a little low, we'll stay a little low.
No, that's what I'm getting at. I don't think
we'll
we want to go to...
We'll say 3,500 to clear your clouds. So look, your track is 220, and that is with wind and everything. Bearing is 219er, and that's where you would have to go to get to your destination. Okay? You get it?
Yeah, no, I get that. I'm just looking at all that rain in front of us and seeing what kind of visibility we get.
Say 35. You can tell approach you like to say at 35.
So we're
Miami
gonna.
Miami departure.
You want to do that?
No, go for it.
No, I mean, you want to set 3,500?
Yeah.
All right. System 429er, maintain VFR below 4,500.
We'll maintain below 4,500 VFR, 64429er. What'd you do?
Fix my thing.
Oh wow, that quieted so much of my earpiece.
Fix the squelch. Alright, look where you're going. Track is 212, you're supposed to go 219er.
You said 219er?
219er, that's your bearing to Marathon.
Yeah, that's what I put here, so I must be off.
Your track is 224, because you have to take into consideration wind. Track will take into consideration wind. So fly this. Get that to 219er, and then you adjust it there. I'll make it a little easier.
There you go, like that.
Oh, I had it. Alright, so keep those two numbers the same. Now you're good. Alright? I just made it a little easier for you.
What'd you do?
I put the bearing right above you. So just keep the bearing and the track the same. There you go, and I centered it for you too.
It's weird. Usually when I turn my head, I can see out. I gotta duck it here. Yes, it doesn't. You kidding? That's our ground speed? 88?
Yep.
Holy crap. Gonna take us an hour.
34 minutes.
Oh, we've been flying for a while, so.
I'll give you the frequencies. Alright, ASOS is 135.52. 525. Yeah, you can put 52 in here.
And then 122.8.
So go ahead and you put that in there. Second one.
No, but we're on which one right now? Come on, okay. And 122.8. Then what's going to happen next? He's going to transfer me over to Miami Center at one point?
Yeah, probably. I'll ask. TMB departure, Cessna 64429.
Cessna 429, Homestead.
I just want to make sure I'm with you on this frequency still.
Skyhawk 429, still have you loud and clear.
Thank
you. Okay, deviate to the left a little bit.
You're good. Watch the bird.
Where? Yeah. Watch the bird, it's kind of generic. Like, where do I need to watch it up for?
Why are you pulling power?
I was redlining almost. Well, a little bit, I guess. So, is it official? Is she actually starting to take classes, or?
She'll probably just do a couple hours.
Oh, she's not going for the full thing?
Nah, I doubt it.
At least she'll know enough to be aware of what's going on when she's in the plane with you.
Yeah.
Niner, contact Miami Center, 124.7. Good day.
124.7, 64429. Alright, where'd you put it in?
First comm. Everything's first comm when you're flying.
American 1429, contact Savannah Center, 124.55.
2455, American 1429, good day.
Miami Center, Skyhawk 64429 at 3200.
Sasky 2212, Miami Center, roger. After tap, Hope, Chris Weaver, Duval 1.
Go back that way.
Yeah.
Number 64429, contact Miami Center, 128.17.
128.7, 64429.
128.17.
And it's 128.17, 2017 for November 429er.
128.17 for 429er.
Alright, Miami American 821, what frequency is Diana Houston?
Houston 124.55.
Alright, thank you.
For Miami American 1378, leveling 16 up. American 1378, Miami Center, roger, climb and maintain, level 370.
370, make 13-7.
There you go. Get the cursor.
American 1378, weather permitting, place uniform Charlie Lima.
Okay, 1-1-17, it's 175.
American 1378.
Which? Call.
This is what, center?
Yeah.
Okay, can you tell me your position? Because I have no idea where I'm at.
Cargo 1308, when weather permits it, proceed direct to Jotpo.
Miami Center, Cessna 64429er, direct Marathon 3000.
We're 64429er, Miami Center, roger.
That's it? Just that's it. Direct Marathon?
Yep.
You don't have to tell them where you're at?
They got you on the radar.
Okay.
You don't have to do that the first time you go in.
Okay, so when you initially call up?
Yeah, if you ask for flight following right now, let's just say you weren't flight following,
right,
you got on,
you
then,
want it.
Then you gotta tell them where you're at.
Okay.
And then what you do is you use the nearest on here. You turn this to nearest, and you say 11 miles from X-ray 551, you know, north of it, or south of it.
Which one did you push, the big or the small one? The big one.
All right, let's get your heading back. Go that way. Actually, let's go that way.
Want to go around the clouds?
Yeah, we'll go that way. Just watch your altitude to keep going down.
Yeah, because of the clouds, but you know.
I know, but you're gonna be careful because if you use the clouds as your reference point.
No, I know that. I keep an eye on the altitude. I know we went down. I just don't want to come in conflict with the clouds since we're VFR.
We're not under 4 Whiskey Miami Center, roger, deviate south of the weather, when able to direct Tamiami.
Start climbing to 35.
Huh?
Climb to 35, you probably have better visibility up there.
Alright.
And then you see that hole over there, between those two?
Uh-huh.
That's where you'll go.
All right. Oh, that's a lot of birds.
Huh?
Those birds are trees.
On cargo 1308, contact Miami approach on 120.5, advise them to direct to Jotpo.
The rigging's off on the plane, because you see how it's turned? Well, where the wing's level? See? Mine's off.
Yeah. I guess one instructor got too scared one time. Ain't did on the right.
Yeah, probably climb, just keep climbing up here.
I'm at 3,500,
yeah, we'll
might as well keep going.
Yeah. We can say 35, because we can go right through these clouds. Yeah, say 35. You're fine here. And then you see that opening over there?
Yeah, that's where I'll go.
Unless you want to have fun between those two. We can have fun. Have you ever done that?
Have done.
Kosky 2212, I'm sure.
You go between
dove in between, turned, and all that.
You want to go between those two?
Miami 3007.
Alright, fine.
Get us back on.
You think that's laterally?
No, but that's okay.
Yeah, well.
Max 61 to maintain 10,000, altimeter at Key West 3009er.
I tell you about there's a flying, I don't want to call it a club, a group on meetup.com.
Yeah, you tell me.
Tomorrow I'm going to go with a guy from North Perry.
Cool.
Make a trip to Okeechobee, get some of those. Here there's some really good omelets in that cafe over there,
yeah,
the Landing Ship Cafe.
Yeah, keep turning because we're about 4 miles off our course. Now you have to head of a heading of 225 to get to where you need to go. You probably shouldn't do so much power changes. It's better for the engine. But my instructor told me he doesn't like to do a lot of power changes unless it's going to land. Because the engine at the constant power won't have any issues, but if you keep changing it, and if something's going to happen, that's when it would happen. It's on power changes. Alright, so you know your heading you're supposed to go?
Well, the track is over there. I need to go to 225.
And what are you at?
250.
Yep.
Once I get around this, I'll get back. You said anyways, we're 4 miles to that side. How did you know it was 4 miles that way? Oh, that one on top. If I kept this, I'd intercept maybe earlier, but the only thing is we're extending.
Yeah, but you're...
Because we're going that way instead of trying to intercept that way.
Yeah, but your intercept, you should be like 15 degrees. I wouldn't go that far of an intercept.
No, I didn't do it to intercept. I just did it to avoid the cloud.
Your intercept would be 225, right there.
This will stay at this altitude. 4,000. You okay with that? 4,500, I guess. Or do I go back?
You can probably stay here for now. I mean, we're going to land in 20 minutes, so...
USC, roger, approved as requested, clear direct.
My old airplane.
Nice and cool up here.
Yeah, compared to on the ground, right? I wonder if we're going to find any of those Tiki platform.
You can listen to
Tiki
the,
platform,
to the ATIS. You already have it in there.
Cut 4376, roger, one able, clear direct, Jank.
Wait, wasn't that it?
Change it?
Yes. Altimeter, 3009er. For marks, density altitude 2000. Marathon Airport, Marathon, Florida. Automated weather observation, 1745 Zulu. Wind variable at 04. Visibility, 10. Sky condition, clear. Temperature. Celsius. Dew point 25 Celsius. Altimeter 3009er. Remarks. Density out.
So what runway you're going? You have 25 and 07.
Well, it's variable, so it doesn't matter.
6-1, turn 10 degrees right.
Call Multicom and find out what's active. No?
Yeah, you can. So when are you going to start your...
You said, that's me, right?
Yep.
The bottom one?
Yep.
15 kilo Alpha 4767, I'll have your IFR just a moment.
We were going to ask.
When are you going to start your descent? How many minutes out?
That's what I was going to calculate. We're going about 100, so we're at 4,000, so by descent of 500 feet, so we'd say about 8 minutes to 10 minutes out. Where do we have the time to... So in about 6 minutes, I could start descending.
I mean, you could have this also like this, and you can put all this stuff here, but that kind of shows you your map. But it doesn't show you all that stuff.
Max 6-1, fly heading 185.
Now, is he, at what point do I look, he transfers me out?
Whenever you want to.
So I can just say terminating.
You don't need to. Stay on.
November 15 Kilo Alpha radar contact 6 North of Marathon 3700. Cleared to the St. Petersburg Airport via radar vectors. Turn left, fly heading 330. Climb and maintain flight level 220. November 9094 Whiskey. Whiskey, contact Miami Approach 120.5. November 64429er. In 8 minutes, in case of lost communication, your next frequency is 133.5.
133.5 for the next frequency, 64429er.
The 2212 Miami Center area is building moderate to extreme precipitation. 12 o'clock and
no, your door is
38 miles, about 15 miles in diameter. Would you like to go left or right around it?
That's all right. Just to let you know.
Cassie 2212, roger. Weather permitting, fly heading. All right, hold on. Let me get you a good heading. SK 2212, weather permitting, fly heading 030 vectors around the weather.
You haven't done a lot of flights.
SK 2212, descend maintain 11,000 B Miami altimeter 3007.
I'm doing a lot more practicing of that.
Look, I put this here for you too. So bearing and your track. This is where you are, this is where you want to go.
November 15 Kilo Alpha, routing when you're ready
bottom
to copy.
Bottom one is my track.
Yeah, your track.
November 15 Kilo Alpha, clear to the St. Petersburg Airport to be a direct Lee County and join the Bridge 7 arrival.
Which way did you go?
Left. Little knob.
Oh, left. You went like this, I thought.
Climb and maintain flyable 220, affirmative November 15 Kilo Alpha.
And now...
MASH 61, contact Key West Approach 124.02 or 313.7.
So you are 15 minutes out, so about 5 more minutes. You have to 4,700.
Brickyard 4376, no. Miami Center, roger.
Yeah, up here you got a lot of time to figure out what you need to do to fix things. If I had an emergency landing right now, I would land in there.
Question. So you set up here everything for your destination and you just switch from here?
Yep.
Every frequency that you're going to? Alright.
That's why you test it on the ground so you have the right volume. Because I've had times that I've had the volume down and I didn't realize that I couldn't hear them calling me because I switched radios in the air. So always checking the ground.
Well, what I do is I put the ground here and I put the tower, so eventually I would switch the tower. You would know it's not working. What I was going to ask,
2212, weather permitting,
when you were asking
Miami.
Which runway, since it's variable, there's no preference.
Right.
So I'll call Multicom and I'll ask him what's the active.
You can do that, or you can make the decision. Think
just
about,
make that
well,
announcement that I'm taking.
You want to get into a pattern, right? You want to go downwind? Then you can just go downwind on that runway. Instead of going a straight and final, and then you can make your pattern. So there's a runway, I think it's 0927.
Is it?
0725. That was close. So if you're going
0725.
So if you're going 21, you could probably go downwind, a left downwind of 07? And then start your base and final. So then you could overfly the runway, you can join the pattern. That's what I would do.
Well, if you're landing 07, you're
going to
enter downwind.
Yeah, you're going to enter downwind.
Where's this thing about overflying the path, the airport?
Caskey 2212. Miami approach request, descend and maintain 5,000.
07.
Right.
And we're here, so we're gonna come midfield, enter left.
No, we're going this way. We're going 21 right now. So the runway's here. We're going this way.
Runway 61 Miami Center, roger.
And then turn and then this way.
Oh yeah.
So then you could overfly. You can see if there's any issues on the runway. All right, you're 12 minutes out. Thank you.
traffic not available.
You understand what I'm saying? With the pattern?
Yeah.
Covering 61, small areas, moderate precipitation, 12 to 1 o'clock, 21 miles, about 5 miles in diameter. If you need to deviate left, of course, is approved, and weather permitting, you may proceed directly to county.
Turning. Make sure you keep popping your head up so you can see what the plane's doing.
So the runway is like this, and right now we're flying this.
Yeah.
But what I'm saying is we're going to enter midfield here.
No, no. What you're going to do is you're just going to come here.
Oh, you want to land on 2-5.
No. Yeah, yeah, 2-5.
That's why you had me confused. I'm like, we're landing on 7. How are we flying over the airport? Oh, okay. 2-5. Yeah, that makes sense.
My bad. That was my fault.
I'm not a total old dude then. Think we could glide to that island? To the left?
Well, see, over here is really shallow.
No, to the left, that island over here.
Traffic 2212, contact Miami approach 125.5.
No.
I wouldn't land there. I can tell it's really shallow right here. If I had to land, I'd probably land there.
Alright, so we're at 10 minutes, so start, well, now I'm even further down, but yeah, we'll start descending slowly.
So when you start descending, you get a full power a little bit, because now you're redlining. You can pull it to the bottom of the arc. There you go. Right here.
What?
2-8.
Oh. Man.
You want to get the last weather report, so check it on number 2.
Sky condition clear. Temperature 3.3 Celsius. Dew point 2.6 Celsius. Marathon Airport, Marathon, Florida. Automated weather observation 1755 Zulu. Wind 190 at 06. Visibility 10.
190.
Sky condition
all
clear.
Right, we'll
temperature 3.
So 190. So 2.5 is still the best option.
Yep. Oh yeah, sure.
Not much here to land on.
Huh?
There's not much to land on here.
Clear direct Atnoch, Alpha, Tango, November, Alpha, Whiskey, expect vectors, Key West.
The good thing about landing in that shallow area is the plane will stick out of the water. It won't sink.
Right.
So they'll see you.
The only thing is it might flip upside down.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. It's still white and it's not going to sink. You're going to flip upside down anyway. That's a given.
That's a little boom.
You're going to flip upside down and all the shit behind us is going to hit us anyway.
Look down for a second and the wind just blows me off.
Yep.
I wonder if I should fly a bit over so that I can let the wind track me over.
Well, this is your track. So whatever you're flying there, it's doing exactly what you'll get there. So if you stay right here, you'll end up, you'll track right there. That's why we use track.
I'm gonna avoid this. Alright, coming up about 2,000.
Challenger, X-ray Alpha Romeo Yankee Kilo, Miami Center, Roger, descend to maintain flight level 190.
So we can switch up without leaving, letting them know we're leaving the frequency?
Yeah, but I don't usually do it until I see the field.
If you tell me, yeah. Okay, you can't just get off without letting them know.
Aero 7674 Charlie, Miami Center, Roger. Before Myers, altimeter 3007.
So it should be somewhere in front of us over there.
I'd probably call her now, let her know that we're losing her at our altitude.
Call who? Miami Center? And tell them we're leaving the frequency?
Yep.
What do you say?
Yeah.
Can you call it at
Miami Center, Cessna 64429er? That's all right, we'll switch. Miami Center, Cessna 64429er.
Cessna 64429er, Miami Center, go ahead.
I just want to let you know we're on your frequency now. We're inbound for Marathon.
November 64429er, Roger, do you have Marathon insight?
Affirmative insight.
November 64429er, Roger, radar service is terminated. Squawk VFR, frequency change is approved, no targets between you and the field. Have a good day.
Thank you for your help. Switching to VFR.
4942, just to maintain 10,000.
Visibility 10.
There you go.
Okay.
Now you call it in. You are?
9
miles.
9 to the northeast.
Marathon traffic, Skyhawk 64429er, inbound for runway 25 at 9 miles to the northeast of the airport.
1,500 and then at 1,500 Marathon. That's how you cancel it. So what I did is, remember she told us...
Yeah, I was going to do the same once I noticed you weren't getting a call.
Switch frequencies and then that's it, until we see the field. Yeah, you're off.
Yeah, it's probably not this island, but that one over there. Then we're gonna land 25, so we'll go over the runway, enter midfield.
We're not gonna go over it.
We're not flying over the runway?
No.
What, you wanna do straight in?
Oh, I see what you're saying. You're gonna go 25.
25 is this way, right?
Yeah.
So do we overfly the runway, enter midfield, and then...
Ask if there's traffic. If there's no traffic, then you can make the decision to go straight.
Oh, we haven't heard anyone on the traffic.
Oh, you to call. Ask.
Alright. And you just asked if anyone's in the traffic?
Yep.
Marathon, Unicom, Skyhawk, 429er. Is there anyone in the pattern currently?
I should have done a cold call.
That's the airport. You can go straight in.
All right.
Marathon traffic, Skyhawk 429er, 5 miles to the northeast of the airport at 1,200, inbound for straight in, runway 25, Marathon.
That was a good radio call.
Yeah, now that I thought about my transmission before making it. Alright, so I assume that's my runway, and I'm seeing like a big runway.
Yep. Harvey, if you're gonna pull that power.
No, I'm not pulling it yet.
Well, it's off the green arc.
Oh, is it?
That's why a lot of people don't make the runways, because they do that, then they freeze up, and then their engine chokes off, and then they can't make the field. Because they do exactly that. They pull it a little early, and then it gets iced up if it's carbureted.
All right, carb. On mode. Make sure you're in. While trying to land without flaps.
Why?
Huh?
Why?
That's just no particular reason, unless I really need to slow down a lot more.
I should do at least one notch.
All right. Just so all the other ones are like, if you can, try to land without a flap. Practice is an emergency landing in a way.
I'd use flaps in an emergency if I needed it. It'll put me a shorter distance.
Are they going down or?
Yeah, there you go.
Oh my god, that took a while to relax.
Marathon traffic, Skyhawk 429er inbound for runway 25, 3 miles to the northeast. On traffic, Skyhawk 429er on final for runway 25, Marathon.
Slow down. I will put another flat.
Put a little bit of power in a minute.
At 85, I want to slow down. Alright, that's about 70. Was 19, right?
Yep.
So to my left, in theory. Alright, looking good. Got a bit of speed though. Whoa.
You're off.
What happened?
You were sideways, you came in sideways.
Realize I was sideways. Alright, I think we got a way to go. Oh no, it's right here, Charlie.
Marathon traffic, Skyhawk 429er, clear of runway 25. Marathon.
This way.
Huh? That way.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what they told me by the end of 25.
Okay.
Do you call when you're taxiing? No?
Yeah, you just call yourself. Just tell them you're taxiing.
Okay. Taxiing to Marathon General ramp. Alright.
Marathon traffic, Skyhawk 429er taxiing to Marathon General Aviation ramp.
That was rough. Sorry about that.
Yeah, you gotta make sure you're straight on the runway. You kept your crab in versus putting a wing down.
I didn't even realize I was still crabbing.
Yep.
I thought it was fine.
Well, you had a crosswind, so you'd be crabbing if you were going straight down the runway if your wing wasn't bent. Think about that.
Oh, the question is how far? When I went to yard nav, it said it was by the runway end of 25.
That's the end.
I don't know, I mean, oh. Yeah, you're right, I don't know which way now. Oh, there's not too many places we have to go here. Well, you said you've been here before, which way did you go? Where'd you go?
The other way, but... Yeah, it's the other way.
Alright.
Actually, I don't know.
I don't see a building, though. See a hangar, but...
Yeah, I think it's the other way.
Do I flip it on the runway or get off the ramp?
Just flip it on the runway.
Not too good at that, but let's see.
I'll do it. Got it. I got it. Alright, you're playing.
Where is this? I think it's this here on the left.
I don't know.
What's the sign say?
Marathon Unicom, anyone on?
I'm here.
Which building is it for us to stop to go get lunch? Is it this green awning one?
Sir, if you're on the taxiway, come on the way up to Alpha 5, and you'll find us up here.
Hello, we're at Charlie.
Roger. Alpha 5, is that towards the approach end of 7?
That's on the east end at approach end of 25.
No. That is the other way.
So we were going the right way.
Yeah, I guess so. All right, Roger, thanks. Yeah, it's the opposite.
This guy must be wondering, what's this bozo doing?
Good.
Cruising the taxiways.
That's why I decided to call. Let me just call. Find out what they said.
Interesting why they didn't answer earlier. I guess
she
just wasn't there. Huh?
You didn't call him?
Yeah, I did.
No, you just...
I called and I asked if anyone was in a pattern.
She's not in a pattern.
No, I asked her if there was any traffic in the pattern.
Nah, the people up in the top will tell you. She doesn't have a radar.
Right, but I thought that's what you told me. Call Multicom and ask them.
You see if anyone's in a pattern. No one's in a pattern.
She didn't answer.
She didn't, but no one would have answered.
Oh, you're saying other people would have answered?
Yeah.
What time is it? Must be like 2 o'clock or close to it.
2:10.
Yeah. Oh, I think that's it there.
Yep.
So, should we park here, I guess, next to these guys? Yeah.
They'll tell you where to come.
That guy, right? Yeah.
Yep.
Try not to run him over.
To pull this back to lean it when you were taxiing, and you forgot to put in the car beat.
I didn't do my
after landing check.
After landing, we were so I was so preoccupied with figuring where to go. Skipping step, not a good idea. All right, not too bad, but definitely not my best flight ever. Thank you for hanging in there.
You're welcome.
Wherever you are in the world, share your aviation. Share Aviation, a network for pilots by pilots.